Now let's consider ohmmeters. A simple ohmmeter can be pictured as a circuit containing an ammeter, a resistor, a power supply, and a pair of leads. When an ohmmeter tests a device, that device completes the circuit. Ohmmeters send a current into the component or circuit under test. The amount of current that flows through the component is determined by the component's resistance. The current is indicated on the ammeter, but the meter's markings are in ohms rather than amps. Most often, ohmmeters are contained as part of a multimeter called a volt-ohm milliammeter, or VOM for short. We'll talk more about multimeters later in this lesson. Portable VOMs have one or more batteries inside to provide the current for the ohmmeter. Electronic multimeters have a power supply, which provides the current that is fed out by the ohmmeter. Some meters have their ohm scale reversed. Infinity is on the left, and zero is on the right. When the leads of the ohmmeter are not connected to a circuit or device, the ohmmeter circuit is open, and no current flows. Thus, the pointer is all the way to the left and is marked with the infinity symbol, which means there is infinite resistance. In other words, resistance is so high that it is uncountable. When the leads are connected directly together, the pointer moves all the way to the right, which is marked zero on the scale, which means there is no resistance whatsoever. That is, a perfect connection allows maximum current flow. All ohmmeters have a potentiometer that allows the meter to be properly calibrated as the meter's voltage changes. This is used to compensate as the battery ages and weakens. On some meters, this control is a zero adjust. When the leads are connected together, the pointer should read zero. On electronic meters, one potentiometer adjusts zero and another adjusts ohms infinity. While many ohmmeters have the reversed scale we've discussed, a different type of ohmmeter circuit is used in electronic meters. It has zero ohms on the left and infinity on the right. Ohmmeter scales are almost always the top scale on a meter and are always non-linear. The scale markings near zero are widely spaced. This is the scale area where most accurate readings are taken. The space between scale markings near infinity is narrow, showing the infinite progression of numbers. Readings here should be avoided. The range switch on an ohmmeter selects different resistors to allow greater or lesser current flow depending on the interference presented by the component being measured. Ranges on an ohmmeter are multipliers. Each is indicated as R times 1, R times 10, R times 100, and so forth. Measurements are taken by first noting the reading indicated by the pointer on the ohm scale. The number is then multiplied by the range setting. For example, if this ohmmeter is set to R times 10, and it measures a resistance of 5 on the meter scale, that 5 needs to be multiplied by 10. The resistance we have measured, therefore, equals 50 ohms. Here's some techniques to be used for proper and accurate resistance measurements. The zero adjust and or ohms adjust setting should be checked each time an ohmmeter is used. The test leads are connected to each other and zero ohms should be indicated. With the lead separated, infinity should be indicated. An ohmmeter should never be connected to a component or circuit that is powered, since an ohmmeter supplies current into the component or circuit it is measuring. If the component or circuit under test is not completely disconnected or isolated from power, the meter could be damaged and incorrect measurements will result. Also, care should be taken that no other components are connected to the component under test. Additional components connected to the component or circuit under test can interfere with the proper measurement. Finally, measurements should always be made on a range that allows pointer indication in the more expanded section of the scale. Measurements made on the compressed side of the scale are less accurate.